We're given f of x and g of x, and asked to determine the following composite function values. The idea of a composite function is that the output of the inner function will become the input of the outer function, giving us the final output of the composition of functions. To visualize this, we can think of a conveyor belt, where we start with the input into the inner function, which gives us an output. And then this output becomes the input into the outer function, giving us a final output for the composition of functions. So looking at our first example, notice how we can write composite function two main ways. These two forms are equivalent, though the second form is easier to work with because we can see the inner function would be g of 2. So to find the value of f of g of 2, we'll first determine g of 2. To determine the value of g of 2, we substitute 2 for x in function g, which would be 2 times 2 squared minus 5 times 2 plus 9. Well, this would be 4 times 2, that's 8, minus 10, that's negative 2, plus 9, that's positive 7. Since g of 2 equals positive 7, f of g of 2 equals f of 7. Notice how the output of g becomes the input into function f. F of x equals 3/5 x plus 4, so f of 7 would be 3/5 times 7, or times 7 over 1, plus 4, plus 4 over 1. Notice our denominator here is going to be 5. Let's convert 4 over 1 to fifths by multiplying by 5 over 5. Notice how we have a common denominator of 5 now. And the numerator would be 21 plus 20, which would be 41. So f of g of 2 equals 41/5. Next we have g of f of 4. So we'll begin by determining f of 4, which is the inner function value. So f of 4 would be equal to 3/5 times 4 plus 4, or 3/5 times 4 over 1 plus 4, or 4 over 1. Again, notice how the common denominator here would be 5. Once again, let's convert 4 over 1 to fifths. Notice now we do have a common denominator of 5. And the numerator would be 12 plus 20, or 32/5. And since f of 4 equals 32/5, we can rewrite g of f of 4 as g of 32/5. So the input into g is now 32/5, so the output would be 2, or 2 over 1, times 32/5 squared minus 5, or minus 5 over 1, times 32/5. And then plus 9, or plus 9 over 1. So let's see what this is going to work out to. 32 squared is 1024. 1024 times 2 would be 2048. So we have 2048 over 5 squared, that's 25, minus 165ths plus 9 over 1. Notice our common denominator is going to be 25. Let's multiply this fraction by 5 over 5. Multiply this fraction by 25 over 25. Notice how now we have a common denominator. The common denominator is 25. So we have 2048 minus 160 times 5 is 800. So minus 800, and then plus 9 times 25 is equal to 225. So 2048 minus 800 plus 225 is equal to 1473. This would be all over 25. This would be g of f of 4. Let's take a look at two more examples. Here we have f of g of 1/2. We'll begin by determining g of 1/2. G of 1/2 would be equal to 2, or 2 over 1, times 1/2 squared, minus 5, or 5 over 1 times 1 half, and then plus 9, or plus 9 over 1. So here we'd have 2 times 1 fourth, that'd be 1 half, minus 5 halves. Let's go ahead and convert 9 over 1 to halves by multiplying by 2 over 2. So that'd be plus 18 halves. Denominator is 2. The numerator would be 1 minus 5, that's negative 4. Negative 4 plus 18 would be 14. 14 divided by 2 equals 7. Since g of 1 half equals 7, f of g of 1 half is equal to f of 7. And f of 7 would be equal to 3 fifths times 7, or 7 over 1, plus 4, or plus 4 over 1. Notice our denominator here is going to be 5. Let's convert 4 over 1 to fifths by multiplying by 5 over 5. Notice our denominator is now 5, and the numerator would be 21 plus 20, or 41 fifths. So f of g of 1 half equals 41 fifths. And now for our last example, we have f of negative 4 fifths. We'll begin by determining f of negative 4 fifths. So f of negative 4 fifths would be equal to 3 fifths times negative 4 fifths plus 4, plus 4 over 1. So we'd have negative 12 25ths, and then let's convert this to 25ths by multiplying by 25 over 25. So we have plus 100 25ths, so this would be equal to, 88 25ths. So since f of negative 4 fifths equals 88 25ths, we can rewrite this composite function as f of 88 25ths. So this becomes the input again into function f. So this would be equal to 3 fifths times 88 over 25 plus 4, or 4 over 1. So notice here we'd have a denominator of 5 times 25, that's 125. 3 times 88 equals 264. Let's multiply 4 over 1 by 125 over 125. So this would be plus, 500 over 125. So we have a sum of 764 125ths, which would be f of negative 4 fifths. I hope you found this helpful.